Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Knowledge Hub. Let's learn together. This is our second video for brick test. Now types of test on bricks. In this video, we are going to discuss about the tests carried out to check the good quality of bricks. There are four major tests: compressive strength of brick, water absorption test on brick, efflorescence test on bricks, and dimension test on bricks. In my previous video, we have seen the compressive strength of bricks. Now, let's begin with the water absorption tests on brick. What is water absorption? Mainly, water absorption tests on bricks are conducted to determine the durability property of bricks, such as a burning quality and behavior of bricks in weathering, because brick is a porous material. A brick with water absorption of less than 7% provides better resistance to damage by freezing. Now, frequency of water absorption test. Water absorption test of bricks is performed at the use of every 50,000 bricks or test when the source of bricks, the class of brick and the type of bricks are changed. It depends upon from which source we have purchased or we have taken that bricks. Water absorption test as per Indian Standard 3495, Part 2, 1992. Apparatus: oven, weight balance, and tray, as you will see in side sketch. Now, preparation of test specimens. Take any 5 random bricks from a lot of brick as a specimen. Dry the specimen in a ventilated oven at a temperature of 105 degrees Celsius to 115 degrees Celsius till it achieves considerably constant mass. Cool the specimen to room temperature and take its weight, that is, we say M1. Testing. When the specimen is completely dry, then immerse it in the clean water at the room temperature, that is 27 plus or minus 2 degrees Celsius, for 24 hours. Remove the specimen from the water after 24 hours and wipe out the water with a damp cloth and weigh the specimen. Take the weight M2, we can say M2 of the specimen after 3 minutes of removing from the water. Now we will see the result. Note down the M1 and M2. The percentage of water absorption of brick by its mass after 24 hours in cold water is calculated by the following formula. That is M2 minus M1 divided by M1 into 100. The test results recommendation is as follows. For first class bricks, the water absorption should not be more than 15%. For second class bricks, the water absorption should not be more than 20%. And for third class bricks, water absorption should not be more than 25%. Now we will see efflorescence test on bricks. Now, what is efflorescence? Efflorescence is an accumulation of minerals and salts on the masonry surfaces, such as brick, cement, sometimes stones, a whitish occurrence, color occurrence on the surface of brick masonry. Efflorescence is a whitish crystalline deposit on surface on the bricks. Usually magnesium sulfate, calcium sulfate and carbonate of sodium and potassium are found in efflorescence. The movement of groundwater into foundations of building and by capillary action into brickwork is very often the cause of efflorescence. Now we will see the procedure for testing efflorescence of bricks. First we see apparatus. A shallow flat bottom dish containing sufficient distilled water to completely saturate the specimens. The dish shall be made of glass, porcelain or glazed stoneware and of size 180 mm to 150 mm to by 40 mm and depth of square shaped and 200 mm diameter into 40 mm depth for cylindrical shape. Distilled water and brick specimens. Now we will see the test procedure. Fill distilled water in a shallow dish and place one end of brick in dish. Water should be filled in dish such that brick should immerse in water up to 25 mm depth. We can see in the side sketch also. Place this whole arrangement in a warm ventilated room such that the whole water is absorbed by the specimen and the surplus water will get evaporated. Cover the dish containing brick with suitable glass cylinder so that there will not excessive evaporation from dish. When whole water gets absorbed and brick appears to be dry, place a similar quantity of water in the dish and allow it to evaporate as before. Now we will see the result of efflorescence tests. Now if the result of efflorescence test shall be reported as nil, slight, moderate and heavy or serious. We can see the efflorescence by the side sketch also. This is whitish portion on the surface of bricks. Nil. If there is no noticeable deposit of efflorescence, slight, when less than 10% of exposed area of brick is covered by a thin layer of salt. Moderate, when there is a heavier deposit than under slight and covering up to 50% of the exposed area of the brick surface but unaccompanied by powdering or flaking on the surface. Heavy, when there is a heavy deposit of salts covering 50% or more of the exposed area of the brick surface but unaccompanied by powdering or flaking of the surface. Serious, when there is heavy deposit of salt acquired by powdering and or flaking of exposed surface. Now we will see the dimension test of bricks. It is as per Indian standard 1077. Dimension test on bricks is done to determine the permissible dimension of common building bricks with permissible tolerances. Now we will see the equipments. Measuring tape. To measure the dimension of bricks, select high accuracy measuring tape. Sample. 20 pieces of building bricks out of selected pieces are taken at random. We will see the sketch. By sketch, measurement of length, measurement of width and measurement of height. Procedure. The bricks are laid flat on the horizontal surfaces. The cumulative dimension of 20 common building bricks are taken at random. The tolerances on the sizes of bricks are fixed by giving maximum and minimum dimensions. Now we will see the table. Subclass A, subclass B bricks are there. Dimension, length, and tolerances. Length 380 mm. For subclass A it is 12 mm less or more. For subclass B it is 30 mm less or more. Width 180 mm. For subclass A it is 6 mm less or more. For subclass B it is 15 mm less or more. Height 90 mm. For subclass A it is 6 mm less or more. For subclass B it is 15 mm less or more. For 40 mm height, for subclass A it is 3 mm less or more, for subclass B it is 6 mm less or more. The measurement shall be repeated at least thrice for obtaining average value, means to take correct value. Result: if it follows from the method of the measurement that batches are likely to contain bricks outside the prescribed limit of tolerances, such lots should be rejected to avoid complaints about the variation of perpends. So we have seen the different tests carried out on bricks to determine its quality, to ensure bricks durability and its uses. If you have any doubts, please comment. Now that's all for today. Please keep watching my channel for interesting topics. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.